Hey guys, Trisha Hershberger here, and a lot of people have already made up their minds regarding which side of the Apple FBI fight they believe is in the right. This video is not to debate which side is right, we'll save that kind of stuff for the naked truth, but to understand exactly what's going on from a tech standpoint. Hold your butts, everybody, because this is gonna go fast. The TLDR version, for anyone who isn't privy to what's been going on, is that a magistrate ordered Apple to help the FBI hack an iPhone used by one of the San Bernardino shooter suspects. Apple wants to keep the security systems they've created in place, and the FBI wants the information in that phone. This encryption slash backdoor debate isn't new, and whatever happens here will set a precedent for these types of cases moving forward. The iPhone in question is an iPhone 5C, presumably running iOS 9. iOS 9 uses two different means to keep user data private. That's a 4- or 6-digit passcode and a 256-bit AES secret key that's built into the phone. The passcode, A, and the key, B, get together and make another key, C. When the correct password is entered, the phone does a calculation to get that final code, and the phone is unlocked. A plus B equals C. Are you following me? On an iPhone 5C, this whole process takes about 80 milliseconds. On top of that fancy business, Apple has an optional auto-erase function that will completely erase the last key, C, if the incorrect password is entered too many times. The data is technically still there, but there will never be a way to decrypt it with part of that equation missing. If the FBI is trying to crack a code, they enter in hundreds or thousands of tries per second until they get the right one. If the phone is secured by a 6-digit passcode, there's around 1 million possibilities. Even if auto erase is not enabled on the phone, thanks to that 80 millisecond calculation, guessing this way could take more than 5 years. On newer iPhones, that calculation takes longer and longer with each failed guess, intentionally to increase user security even more. Now, Apple has unlocked phones for court orders before, but this was before iOS 8 secure encryption. They've even locked themselves out. Almost. There's still one way to access the data on the phone used by the suspect, and that's to create a special, less secure version of iOS and install it on the phone. Once the delay and auto-erase features are out of the picture, the FBI could then begin trying to crack that code. So, that's it. Whether you side with Apple in the only way to keep our users safe is to never create something like this camp, or you side with the FBI in the only way to keep our citizens safe is to find the truth at all costs camp, I hope that this video helped make it a little bit easier to understand. If you like this video, please like this video and subscribe for more tech, gaming, and the naked truth. Bye-bye now.